happening life in one police station. Police e bugo mado again. Now and mado e jugo life. Opposite the guy in Diego, the guy has no really home. Document to the guy is zoo. Okay, I'm here, but Bobo, the guy, I will go. Police, Bugo Madden, the Nigeria, no funny how happening life, Owani police station.
Happening life at Owani police station in Enugu State. This is a current news. Today's date is 30th of August 2021. When we tell our people to stay at home on Monday, every Monday, it is called Nnamdi Kanu's Day. They refuse to listen because this is an Igbo adage. Ijijintike ne sozu abanili. Our people refuse to understand the handwriting on the wall. What is that thing that is more important to you than your freedom? What is that thing that you cannot sacrifice for our leader Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, who has sacrificed everything sacrificable in his life, including his dear freedom? He has sacrificed everything. He has his family. He's supposed to take care of them. But this is making it the third time he is going inside as a captive because of Biafra. The first one was very early. Nobody heard about it. The second one was in 2015. Then this is the third one. The third time because of us. But you cannot sacrifice anything to get your own freedom. You are not sacrificing for anybody, not for me. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is sacrificing for me and for you, but you as a person cannot sacrifice for your own self, for your own freedom, not even for me. Can you imagine that? How our people, some of our people, I don't know how to qualify them. Look at this man, abled man, a car owner, just wasted today in the broad daylight. You can see it, the video, you just watch the video right now. This is not an audio. You are not just listening to my voice alone. I have shown you the video. And your duty is to share it so that it circulates everywhere. Our people will know that the zoo is not happy for this sit at home. The zoo government, the zoo security operatives, no one is happy for this very sit at home that has continued. Even as they pressurize the DOS to suspend it, yet the Biafrans know what they want. They continue the sit at home in solidarity to our leader Mazi Nnamdi Kanu and for our freedom. So the zoo is not happy. Things are not well in their carcass. This is something that our people must understand. There are no two ways about it. This is very clear. They are not happy. You had Hopeless Uzo Dinjo day before yesterday blabbing and the propagating lies and deceit, telling the media that Imo State observe jamb and all that nonsense. When we showed videos everywhere, or when a video or no video gig everywhere last Monday, Imo State was completely shut down. Who is that fool that will release his child or her child to go for that useless jamb on Monday, 16th of August last week? Oh, sorry, 23rd of August. Who is that coward that will accept to release his child? Where did they take that exam? All schools were shut down, banks were shut down, markets were shut down. Every activities in the whole of Imo State were crippled on 23rd of this very month of August. That is last week Sunday, Monday. The same thing happened today. The whole of Imo State was completely shut down, or should I say, is completely shut down today. Yes, that idiot, for him to come to propagate lies, tell lies to media, shows you very well that they are not happy. And once we continue this thing, I can assure you, my brothers and sisters, this is the ifabo hama nantu, IG hama nantu, now my government no be. IG hama nantu, you know, people do not understand it. That's why in this very platform, we have been shouting, we have been crying, we have been, you know, we took it upon ourselves. Let them call it act of insubordination. We took it upon ourselves to propagate this very message. The seat at home must continue, no matter what the DOS said. And it continued. So we knew it. We used the experience of 30th of May this year, the year 2017 and the year 2015. We know how difficult it was for government to run their activities that very day, and how they fought very, very hard to stop that sit at home. The time our leader was in prison, when UHMFO, the DJ, was the deputy, leader. We had sit at home in 2017. We all saw what happened. So those experiences are very, very fresh in our mind. That is the reason why we propagated it. We circulated the news, make sure that the news went viral, that sit at home should continue. And they called it act of insubordination. But I can assure you today is paying off. You could see what is happening. People are not happy. The government is not happy. The government officials are not happy. The operatives, security operatives are not happy. Yesterday and day before yesterday, they were using gong, ekwe na ogene, in Imo State, in Olu to be precise. Na ekwe na ogene, telling people on Monday they should come to open their businesses, that security is intact. In Olu, I got the information from the right source. The best source, somebody who was there live, is the one who gave us that very information in Olu yesterday and day before yesterday. Yesterday was on 29th, which was on Sunday. Olu, they were using police officers and army, Jekwe Nogele Naku, tank raya, Nagale everywhere, telling people that they should come out today to open. And people refused because they know that they are calling them to come out for them to be killed. They were just calling them to come out so that the army will shoot them. This is propaganda. People understand it and they stayed home. But look at now. Look at what happened in Enugu State. Today. Not just today, few minutes ago. Look at it. An able-bodied man just lost his life. A car owner lost his life for nothing. For stupidity and ignorance. Because of Ihafo Geli. That is the reason why he refused to sit at home, in at least, even if you don't believe, even if you are not an IPOB member, even if you don't believe in Biafra struggle or Biafra restoration, why can't you see this man, this very man who has sacrificed everything in his life to save mankind, to save humanity, to save us from extinction, to save us from humiliation, to save us from Islamization, to save us from Fulanization, to save us from extermination in the hands of Fulani Caliphate, in the hands of Fulani terrorists. This man has been shouting, formed ESN with nothing. With nothing. There is no any big man, no rich man, not even Obi Kubana, who is busy taking picture with a murderer, Abba Kyari, who is killing his own people, and today he has been indicted in USA. No, not even Obi Kubana sent a single cent to fund ESN. A man from nowhere just came, said, let us do this. A Hibe security that has given Fulani run. In Igbo land, in Biafra land as a whole, not just Igbo land. But no Igbo rich man, not even Ifa Nyoba, they are busy talking about politics. What a shame. How comes Igbo, an envied tribe, a tribe that the whole world has notified, the whole world knows very well that these people are such a unique and I don't know which language I can use to qualify the quality of Igbo. But today, look at what our people have turned Igbo people as to be laughing stock. If not for this resilience of sit at home that we have taken upon ourselves, even after the suspension, we have shown them that thing you normally compare us as money lovers of money, business oriented set of people. We can give that Monday, we can get rid of Monday, which is the main day, the busiest day in a week. We can give it out for our freedom, for the freedom of our leader. We have shown that, and now you have seen that our dignity is returning one by one. Slowly, slowly, we are now regaining our dignity. For us to come together, to hold our hands together, to say, we must continue this. Thank you, my people. This one, this very thing that happened now, should be an eye-opener to everybody that on Monday next week must be total shut down in the whole of Biafra land. Share this news and make it go viral.